Mahatma Gandhi had a maxim which I think works very well, and that is, when you're working with government, cooperate where you can, resist where you must. But firstly, where must we resist? And I think that, you know, I think the 21st century is a time of churning of ideas in every country in the world. Every UN body needs to define, firstly, what are the frontiers that cannot be crossed? And if these frontiers are crossed, what should be its response? Clear about non-negotiables, especially in relation to the specific mandates of each organization. And when those frontiers are crossed, to be sure that you will be a public voice with a reasoned, quietly reasoned, but evidence-based, principled public response. Because it is important to have a relationship with your governments, it's important to work closely with them. But it cannot be at the cost of the most fundamental principles of what we stand for. The first principle for me is last person first. Last person first. Think of the weakest, the most oppressed, and think of whether this policy will make sense to that person. And what is life like for her, and what needs to be done. The second is to create a very strong empirical basis to understand exclusion. There's no reason why you can't support independent organizations which have credibility to bring out things like an exclusion report, and we're doing that, for instance, in India. And I found that it's really important to bring this evidence. But I think it's even more important to influence public opinion, because governments will change. So the second thing is about creating a strong empirical base to influence, on the one hand, policymakers, but more importantly, public opinion, especially around issues of exclusion. It's also about the questions of minorities and how they're treated in our societies. The third is to build capacities and relevant new knowledge. And the fourth is about model building, which demonstrates how you can make a difference to that last person. Showing that that can be done is a very powerful way. So very, very strategic program interventions for model building to influence policy. So I think that demonstrating with that last person in mind, with rights, with state and public responsibility, that things are possible, are very important examples. But in the end, the UN has relevance only if it is willing to take sides, and sides with that last person publicly. Thank you.